Matthew Lee with the Tao of Kung Fu. Hope everyone's doing well today. Thanks again for the subscriptions and the shares and the likes. I'm appreciating all the comments so much. Keep it up and let me know what you'd like to see in upcoming videos. Today, I wanted to talk about one of the aspects of Tai Chi and Bagua that aren't spoken of real frequently. Once again, it's a difficult subject because it's hard to explain and it takes a lot of time to develop the practice. But if you just try a little bit here and there, it's one of those things that you can't really force it because you'll kind of hurt yourself and make your practice more difficult. But if you just start thinking about it a little bit as you're doing your training, you will develop this skill and it will help you immensely with everything. So this subject is what is called the quad, which is down in the hip area, and it is an opening and a closing position and a rising and a sinking position of basically your hips. And what you get is different power generation and different type of movement as you're developing this opening and the closing of these quad. So to explain, let me get up and we can maybe see how this works. So you've got these hip bones that are called the ilium, and these are basically what you're focusing on, because visually those are what you can see when you're training in a mirror and you're recording yourself to look at playback video of what's going on. When they say to rock your hips forward or thrust forward just a little bit gently and settle into the knees for Tai Chi, they're setting the quad in a specific area so that it's a gentle thrust, it's a little slight opening of the quad. So if this area is stretching and opening, then it is an open quad. So this is like double open. And when you do double closed, it's more of like a Wing Chun stance where you're settled into it still. You're not pooching your butt way out. You're settled into it, but the quad close. And it's really dramatic to bring the knees together. You don't have to do that. You just have to close the quad. And the back can still remain fairly straight, whether it's open or closed, because it's a hip positioning, not a rocking forward or rocking back. So the people that can do this great are dancers, because they specifically develop this type of movement, especially belly dancers. They can move like crazy. They've got the muscles defined and the hips open. So it takes a little bit of hip flexibility, and that's where a lot of the end strengthening of the little muscles around here. So again, don't force it, but you want to work on it so that you feel comfortable with it. So if you go one closed and one open, it twists you real frequently around one way. And that's how things like Bagua work. And then this one will toe out, and as you start to press and step, it goes from being open, and this one starts to close and reaches out. So that is what's happening. And that way, you're creating movement starting from your dantian. So how they say your movement begins with the dantian. This is one of the things they're talking about. So the dantian is in this area. If you go just behind that, think of the dantian as your intention. So you set the intention in the dantian. This is a little bit of a deep subject for this, but this is where how it works. The intention goes to the dantian. The dantian communicates with the spine, and the spine relates to the quad what to do. So the spine is the handle of the whip, and the spine starts to move and it moves the whip. So you move this portion of the spine and it opens or closes the quad. And then that sets your intention for how to move. So when we are doing like our Tai Chi, First thing, we're opening and sinking. So the dantian thinks sink, and the spine starts to sink, and it gets heavy and presses down the legs. Then the spine rises, and the kwa come up with it, and we sink back down to it. So it doesn't look like there's a lot of movement happening in the hips, but it is. There's rising and sinking happening in here, to where you don't notice it as much if they're double rising or double sinking. What you notice is when one rises, like Conan when he does the hip shake, or when belly dancers do the pelvis thing, right? That's where you see it. So it's much more subtle when it's both up, both down. When we go to open up this way, this one will close. So it closes in here, and we can set the weight back without having to push or pull with the feet. Like, you don't want to do this and step. You want to do a little figure eight where you close, and then our weight's shifted and it's all smooth. And then as you step, we start to open, and this one closes to pull us in, right? And that's what's happening. We open, step. This kwa drops and opens. Then this one opens, this one closes, this one closes. So the kwa movement is what you want. Where you see this really frequently is when we're doing Tai Chi or we're doing Bagua and we go to strike. Even in Xing Yi looks the most linear because it is striking straight in, but the circular motion is in the kwa. So that's where the rotational energy, the opening and closing happens. And that's where Fa Qing happens too, is by opening the kwa or closing the kwa. So you get that big handle of the whip. It moves at the kwa first. So with Tai Chi, you see it when you're doing straight lines. This is somebody that doesn't have the right idea, or the hips are too bound when you're just going forward and back. So what you want is like a little figure eight movement. If you just draw a figure eight where you're rotating, and that's what you want as you're here, pulling, rotating, pushing, pulling, rotating, pushing. So the hips are in this little figure eight pattern. And that's what's gonna help you with your rooting, because then instead of working on one line, you're able to work all these different angles. And it'll really help you with your balance. Where you think of your balance as being linear, you do a little kwa movement, and then all of a sudden, you start falling this direction, you can move your kwa. And it'll help you keep your balance. It takes a little while to develop that muscular strength and to get the hips open. You have to do some stretching. You gotta get the IT band needs to be stretched, the hamstrings need to be stretched. The hips have to be open. So you gotta do some like figure four hurdle stretches, some split stretches, and stuff like that. But it doesn't take a whole lot to be able to do this. It just takes a little bit of patience. So say we're doing our Bagua stepping, all right? This will be one we can all do together. So first, this one closes, this one opens, and then we open and close. So then as we start to step around, we're going to shift the weight this way, with the kwa. So it's gonna close here, which is going to press us out that way. It brings our center of gravity into here. And then we can open this one and we can press forward where we start to step. And the cool thing about this, with the control of the quad, you're able to do this as slow or fast as you want. So then we can open. Now when we want to start walking our circle, we're going to not put any pressure on the knee, and the quad are gonna help with this. So you want to open this hip, push forward with this hip. By the time the weight is on this leg, our knee and our toe are pointing the same way. So we're really good. And we've got that twist still in our upper spine. So then we can step out with this one and plant it. Then we can rock forward by opening this quad a little bit and stepping into this one. So then we're gonna close, set, and open just a little. And then that'll help keep us going around the circle. Right? And that way, we're not doing the usual thing, which is falling forward and catching ourselves, stepping around that way, where we've only got that potential to step. To step back, we have to lean back and then step the other direction. So it's keeping us, it's allowing us to have good balance and control of the movement, to where if I want to step that direction next, I can. I've got complete control over all of my movement, where I've got good power and good centeredness and good balance. So the best thing about it is it takes off the stress from the knees. It doesn't matter if you're, you don't pull forward as much with this leg, so it takes the stress off the knee. You don't have to push forward as much with this leg because the hips are helping you work, and the hips are a bigger joint, more close to the center of gravity, so your movement is more efficient and stronger and more balanced. So you're not having to constantly catch yourself, recuperate, push, step, pull, recuperate, catch. Instead, you're balanced the whole time as the quad work, and you can get that great feel of fluid stepping, right? So work on the quad training, and then let me know if you have any questions. As always, like, subscribe, share the videos, and there'll be plenty more to come soon. Thanks for watching.